Hi, I'm Daria Fissoun, and in this video, I'll be showing you how to read and use histograms while color grading. The general descriptions in this video are applicable across any equipment or software that features histograms, but I'll also be going over some of the histogram parameters unique to OmniScope. Let's get started. A histogram shows the distribution and amounts of values in an image. Most commonly, it is used to represent luminance, with the horizontal axis gradating from pure black on the left to pure white on the right, and the vertical axis showing the number of pixels in the image that have those values. Camera operators often use histograms in their viewfinders to objectively and consistently expose a scene. If the histogram is touching either end of the graph, it could mean that your footage is under or overexposed. A well-exposed scene tends to appear evenly distributed within the histogram scope, but it's always important to keep the context of the shot in mind. A night scene will naturally lean left. A beach scene on a sunny day will lean right. You may also have creative reasons for clipping the image at either extreme. Right-click within the histogram window to reveal the scope's contextual menu. Here, you can change the histogram mode to focus on different aspects of the video signal. RGB mode will show an overlay of the red, green, and blue channel values, which can be helpful for spotting color dominance. When working in this mode, you have the option to split the RGB channels for distinct readouts of each channel's intensity. The Luma mode shows the collective luminance of the image, which is better suited for setting exposure and matching shots. For example, when this scene cuts from one shot to the next, the difference in the shadows is jarring. This is supported by the scope, which shows us that the shape of the histogram in the second clip is more compressed towards the shadows. Using primary grading tools like lift, shadow, or the lower midtones of the YRGB curve, I can restore the shape of the histogram, getting it to more closely resemble the first clip and producing a more consistent sequence. Hue mode shows the distribution and amount of colors in the image. Take note of the gradient under the trace to see how the colors are mapped on the horizontal axis. And finally, you can use the saturation mode to monitor and match saturation levels across clips in a scene. Now remember, you can have as many windows in your OmniScope layout as you like. If you want to monitor both Luma and Hue, just open two histogram scopes and set them up accordingly. You can even rename them so you can easily track their function. And while we're looking at layouts, you can also toggle the histogram scope between horizontal and vertical distribution to better accommodate its placement among the other scopes. When you drag in the source signal viewer, that section of the frame will also be isolated in the histogram, allowing you to quickly assess exposure in specific areas. Hold Shift and drag to keep the selection in place until your next click. There's also lots of ways you can interact with the histogram scope itself. Drag in the graph to monitor a range in the viewer and other scopes. A readout in the upper left corner of the source signal window will define the numeric values of the selected range. Hold Shift while dragging to keep your selection in place. You can do this in any histogram mode to create luminosity, hue, and saturation masks. In fact, you can combine these actions to further refine your qualifier selections. Let's say I wanted to accurately assess the color of this woman's shirt. First, I'll hold Shift and drag in the source viewer to separate the shirt from the blue sky in the back and keep the selection in place. I'll then set the histogram to hue mode and Shift-Drag to isolate the blue shirt. I now have a clear readout of her shirt in the waveforms and vectorscopes, which will help me evaluate it and adjust it in my grading software according to the hue predefined by my client. I'll then click in the source signal and histogram windows to reset their respective qualifiers. Use your mouse scroll wheel to change the vertical zoom of the histogram. Hold Ctrl or Command for more refined zoom control. Double-click or middle-click to reset the zoom. Back in the contextual menu, you'll find more controls in the Settings menu. Under the Display tab, you can further configure the appearance of the scope. You already know modes, RGB splitting, and orientation, but here you can also specify if your vertical histogram trace is distributed left to right or right to left for easier readability in your layout. The Fill Opacity determines the transparency of the histogram trace relative to the graticule lines. You can opt to hide or render the histogram edge for a clearer distinction of the histogram values, and choose to hide or show the gradient projected across the x-axis. When working on a scene with significant value peaks, The trace might be hard to read due to the remaining values appearing scaled down relative to those peaks. Adaptive scaling will clip the outliers of the trace to produce a more readable histogram. Enabling smooth graph will result in an easier to read but still accurate histogram graphic. Without smoothing, you'll see the histogram in block mode, which tends to feature more variety between individual range values. And in OmniScope Pro, you have the ability to assign custom targets. Enable one of the targets to place a marker in the histogram and then drag the slider to set its position in the graph. The correlation is direct, so to place the marker in the middle of the histogram, set the target to 50. You can use these targets to meet specific legal values or set saturation limits, among many other uses. I hope this video has given you a better understanding of how you can utilize histograms in your projects. Please check out the video description for more information about this and other scopes on the Time & Pixels website. Also, we really appreciate you pressing the like button. Subscribe to be notified of new tutorials and OmniScope feature announcements.